Hello students, in this audio presentation I will continue with the same chapter, the portrait of a lady. So let me continue from where I left and let me continue with a new paragraph. So let's get started. As the years rolled by, we saw less of each other. Interaction between Kushwant Singh and his granny were less after both of them were shifted to the city to live with Kushwant Singh's parents. Their interaction was less. It was more in the village. Now it is quite less. For some time, she continued to wake me up and get me ready for school. When I came back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught me. I would tell her English words and little things of Western science and learning, the law of gravity, Archimedes' principle, the world being round, etc. This made her unhappy. She could not help me with my lessons. As I told you, there was impact of Western science and learning on Kushwant Singh. So terms like the laws of gravitation, Archimedes' principle, then the earth being round, etc. These are scientific topics, or rather to say the theories or subject matter is purely related with science. So unfortunately, it is not possible for his grandmother to aid him or help him with his studies. That was the reason she used to stay very, very unhappy. She could not help me with my lessons, and this was the big reason why she used to be unhappy. She did not believe in the things they taught at the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. She was literally very depressed because there was no teachings about God and the religious scriptures. One day, I announced that we were being given music lessons. She was very disturbed. To her, music had lewd associations. Actually, dear students, the meaning of lewd is inferior. It was the monopoly of harlots and beggars and not meant for gentlefolk. Now, according to her backdated mentality, music is practiced only by the prostitutes. Actually, harlot means prostitutes, and by the beggars. And according to her, music should not be practiced by the genteel people of the society or by the gentlefolk. She said nothing, but her silence meant disapproval. She really talked to me after that. Slowly and slowly, it seems that with the passage of years, she hardly interacted with Kushwant Singh. And when she came to know that Kushwant Singh was given music lessons in the school, she got very, very unhappy because she was totally against Western education. That was the main thing. Now, it was like adding fuel to the fire when she knew from Kushwant Singh that music lessons were also given. She got really very upset with the entire school procedure of academic learning in which her grandson was involved in. And with the passage of time, she hardly talked with Kushwant Singh. So, dear students, now I am moving on to the next paragraph. When I went to university, I was given a room of my own. So for higher studies, when Kushwant Singh went to university, Kushwant Singh used to stay in a hostel along with his friends. At that time, he was given a room of his own. The common link of friendship was snapped. The common bond of friendship that he shared with his grandmother, it was totally broken. My grandmother accepted her isolation or seclusion with resignation. She really, really means hardly. She really left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. From sunrise to sunset, she sat by her wheel, spinning and reciting prayers. She went into her own world of silence and isolation. Dear students, I am repeating this term once again. She went to her own world or into her own world of silence and isolation. She used to involve in her spinning wheel and she used to recite prayers. And she hardly talked with anyone in the family also. Only in the afternoon, she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. Because by this time, you all know it. It has been told by me also that now it was no longer dogs. The friendship now she developed with sparrows. And in the afternoon, it was the happiest time of her day that she spent with the sparrows. At that time, she looked very, very happy. So let me continue. While she sat in the veranda, breaking the bread into little pieces or bits, hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirpings. Some came and perched on her legs, others on her shoulders. Some even sat on her head. She smiled, but never shooed them away. It used to be the happiest half hour of the day for her. Now, she used to feed the sparrows by giving them breadcrumbs. And hundreds of sparrows used to gather around her. And she never shooed them away. She developed a bond, a friendship with those sparrows. And during the afternoon, the time that she spent along with the sparrows, it was the happiest time of the day for her. Now, I am moving on to the next paragraph. When I decided to go abroad for further studies, I was sure my grandmother would be very upset. I was very sure my grandmother would be totally upset with me. I would be away for 5 years, and at her age, one could never tell. It is very unpredictable because she is also getting old. So I am not sure whether I will see her alive after I return back from abroad. But my grandmother could. She was not even sentimental. But my grandmother, she never showed any emotions whatsoever. She was not sentimental at all. She came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk or show any emotion. Now, she came to see me off. That means she came to meet with Kushwant Singh when Kushwant Singh was eager to go abroad for 5 long years for studies. But she never cried or she never showed her emotions. She was not sentimental, just like other ladies of her age. Her lips moved in prayer, but her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. Silently she kissed my forehead, and when I left, I cherished the moist imprint as perhaps the last sign of physical contact between us. Now, it seems that she went on praying, and finally she kissed on Kushwant Singh's forehead. Kushwant Singh thought that maybe this is the last sort of physical contact with his grandmother, because maybe after 5 years, when he will return back, maybe at that time his grandmother may not be alive. So he thought that maybe this moist imprint of kissing on his forehead by his granny might be the last form of physical contact between them. So, dear students, I stop in this tutorial audio here only. I will continue from the next paragraph in my next tutorial audio. I hope that you will listen to it and if there is any problem, kindly let me know. Thank you, students. Thank you all.